Do you want to customize your alert notifications so they look like the way you want? I'll show you how to customize, format, and reuse alert notification messages. There are two ways of templating your alerts in Grafana: templating the alert rule, annotations, and labels, or templating notifications. So what's the difference? If you template inside an alert rule, you can use Go templating in the labels and annotations. This means you can customize what each alert instance looks like. For example, adding the instance name, the metric value, or other useful context. By the way, if this is the first time you're creating an alert rule, or you're hearing about alert instance, I will advise you to check out any of these previous tutorials. The other case is using notification templates. Here, you're not templating the alert rule itself, but the message that Alert Manager or Grafana Alerting sends out. These templates can be shared across contact points, so you don't have to rewrite the same format every time. Plus, they let you control not just the annotations, but also the title and the full body of the notification. This gives you much more flexibility in how your messages are structured. Think of it like this: templating labels and annotations is like writing a note on the inside of a letter. It's part of the alert itself. Notification templates, on the other hand, are like designing the envelope and deciding how a letter is presented when it gets delivered. We can say it's a design of reference for all letters sent to a particular contact point. And one last important thing to note: while both role templates, labels and annotations, and notification templates use the same templating language, the variables and functions available are different. This is one of the most common mistakes beginners make. So if you are reusing an example or writing your own templates, always make sure you are checking the right reference section of the docs for labels and annotations or for notification templates. We've got examples for both. Okay, let's walk through how templating works in Grafana Alerting. First, we start with the alert rule query. In this example, the query returns a value, along with some labels, like the instance and the job. Now, since the value crosses the threshold we define in the alert rule, the alert fires. At this point, we have what's called an alert instance. The alert instance also generates a summary, and this is where templating comes in. The summary text is defined in the alert rule using a template. In our case, the template says, "Show me the instance label and its value." So the summary ends up saying server 1 88, as in 88% of usage. Next, the alert instance is sent off to Alert Manager. Alert Manager is the component that takes care of what happens after an alert fires. It receives alerts and then decides where those alerts should go. In other words, it's responsible for figuring out the right contact point, basically who should be notified. Finally, Alert Manager takes the contact point's notification template, uses it to format the actual message, and sends that notification out. Now that we have seen how templating works, let's build on that by creating an alert rule with annotations that we will later use in our notification template. You can follow along in Grafana Cloud, in the interactive environment, or with Grafana OSS locally. Let's log into Grafana and head to Alerts and IRM, Alerting Alert Rules. Click New Alert Rule and give it a name. In the Queries section, I will use the test data data source with a CSV scenario that simulates multiple time series, each one generating a separate alert instance. For the alert condition, keep last as the reducer function and set the threshold to is above 75. Then preview the condition. You will see some series firing and some normal. Next, we will organize the rule into a folder. By the way, while it's possible to template labels here, in this tutorial we focus on templating the summary and annotations fields instead. Next, set the evaluation group and interval. Choose a 1 minute interval and keep depending and keep firing times at zero, so the alert triggers and resolve quickly for the demo. In the notifications section, pick a contact point or create one if needed. Finally, let's create a summary annotation template. This template inserts the instance name from labels and its CPU usage from values A, with tabs and line breaks for readability. Here is how it looks in a notification. You can also add a description to give on-call engineers more context about what this alert means. Click Save Rule and we're done. Now that we have configured an alert rule with a template for the summary annotation, the next thing we will learn is customize the alert notification themselves. While the default notification message includes the summary annotations and works well, we can do much more than that. We can change the entire message and tailor it to our needs. We will use a built-in notification template that references the summary annotation we just set up. As mentioned before, in this step, we will use a built-in notification template to format our alerts. If you want to dive deeper, you will find more examples in the docs. Let's go to Alerts and IRM, Alerting Contact Points, and open the Notification Templates tab. Click Add Notification Template Group, give it a name, then choose Print, Firing, and Resolve Alerts from the Examples menu. This template organizes alerts into two sections, Firing and Resolved. Each section includes only the key details, plus the summary and description annotations we set up earlier. At the top, the custom firing and resolve alerts block prints the number of resolved alerts, then loops through each one and applies the alert summary and description subtemplate. Next, it does the same for firing alerts, listing how many there are and their details. The alert summary and description section controls the formatting for each alert. It pulls in three key fields: the summary annotation, the alert status, and the description annotation. In the preview area, you can see a sample of how the notification will look. Since we have already created our alert rule, you can take it a step further by previewing how an actual alert instance from your rule will appear in the notification. Click Edit Payload, then click Use Existing Alert Instance. You should see our alert rule listed on the left. Click the alert rule, select an instance, and then click Add Alert Data to Payload. Notice the alert instance is added to the bottom of the preview. Click Save and our template is ready. Next, we will apply it to a contact point to see it in action. In contact points, edit your contact point. Go to optional settings section. Click Edit Message. Under Select Notification Template, search for our custom firing and resolve alerts template. Click Save. Finally, save your contact point. Now that the template has been applied to the contact point, you should receive notifications in the specified contact point. If you templated an email contact point, the notification template should look like this. And this is how it should look like if you chose Slack as your contact point. You can see how the notification template groups the alert instances into two sections, firing alerts and resolved alerts. Each section includes only the key details for each alert. Great job! You have just learned how to configure alert rules with annotations and customize them using built-in notification templates. But we are not stopping here. In the next tutorial, we will take it a step further, routing alerts based on dynamically generated labels. That way, critical alerts go directly to the on-call team, while less urgent ones flow into a general monitoring channel. See you there!